It is back day. We have a very fitting back day plan today. We have a back day plan that involves nothing but bands, barbells,
bands and barbells.
And yeah, bands and barbells.
Yeah, bands and barbells. Okay, yeah, we don't even need dumbbells. Just bands and barbells. So,
a barbell.
Yeah, right.
And bands.
Not even plural.
And plates.
Take the lots of plates. Anyway, right. Order of things that we're going to do, and in recent fashion, how we've been given, you know, the more detailed instruction for each exercise. We'll do that when we get to it. Without further ado.
Yeah, and our and also the platform is homemade, so.
Yeah, it's super homemade. we'll show you all again. We showed you last back workout, but it is super MacGyver. So, anyways, let's get to it. All right, guys, so first up on the list for our quarantine-style back workout is straight-arm pushdowns with the band. So, straight-arm pushdowns, we've gone over this one before, but to give you all a refresher on this one, without, you know, talking about the band, what we're aiming to do with this exercise is to keep our lats engaged the whole time and stretch them. Not just stretch them without them being engaged, which is a mistake a lot of people do with this exercise. You'll see them get all the way out like that, and while their lats fully stretched like that, it's not engaged. By getting our scapula retracted, our elbows turned in, you know, not rotating out, and getting that lat really engaged, we're able to keep that active range of motion while stretching. And then we go, we get a full contraction to here, keeping the elbow close at the bottom, which is something cool the band affords is literally, as you get through the range of motion, you can really turn your elbows and pin to your sides, really get good lat engagement. So I'll let Bryan do a walk around and kind of talk y'all through the exercise while I'm doing mine. But, you know, really pay attention to the elbow position, the shoulder position, how I keep the retraction the whole time and get that good ringing out of your arm, if you will. You know, ring it out to get that lat engagement. So, here we go. So that's fully stretched but not engaged. That's fully stretched.
So how he's going to initiate the move is pulling his scapula back, contracting his scapula. There you go. And pulling through the full range. Notice how his arms do not change the position. They stay about the same amount of bent throughout the motion. He's not coming on his toes too much or on his heels too much. So you can see he's wearing a tank top. His lat contraction. Contracting.
And I guess one really good tip for this exercise to kind of illustrate how you don't need to like really let everything hang so much in your range of motion, especially for bigger people, really isn't as much as you think, is stick your hands straight up like this and then rotate your thumbs out as hard as you can and maintain that rotational pull and then raise your arms up. However far you max out on, that's the active range of your lat. If you go any higher, you're rotating out and losing engagement to get up to here. The second I lock my shoulders down and lock my elbows down, I'm back to where I was. I can't go any higher than this. This is my active range. So that's a good thing to keep in mind when doing these, is you want to work for the active range.
You should just keep on going and we should leave this in.
Just leave this in.
It didn't suck that bad, right? So all in all, basically, you're shooting your hips back when you're in the stretch position to be able to get a little bit more tension out of the band, because it drops off enough to where it doesn't really keep that much tension on the top, but watch. He'll go to the top and not hinge it at his hips. So go to the top. That's not hinged. You can see how much stretch the band is. Now watch when he hinges at the hips. He gets another couple inches of stretch out of the band. So that's what we're aiming to do with it.
What's up, guys? So it's Tuesday. Last Tuesday I started where I dubbed the Tuesday tip, so I'm going to stick to what I said and give y'all another tip today and keep them coming. Today I wanted to share with y'all a great option for loading your lat slash upper back musculature with very limited equipment.
The exercise I'm going to show y'all today is a rack chin. I'm in no way claiming credit for this exercise. I learned it from Dante Trudel. There's a bunch of guys that use these regularly, but why I'm showing y'all right now is it's a great exercise with very limited equipment. So what you're going to need to do this is basically a rack and then a bench, or you know, you can get super creative, anything. You can get a bar to hang and your feet up, basically. And why is this superior to a pull-up is probably a question a lot of y'all are going to be thinking when y'all watch this. Let me cover that real quick. By having your feet up, it allows you to do a couple things. It allows you to keep your torso more vertical, because when you do a pull-up, you'll end up like this a lot of the time. By doing this, you are held pretty much completely vertical, and you're allowed to really engage your lat a lot more than your upper back musculature like you do with a pull-up, especially when you get tired. The second thing having your feet up affords you the ability to do is to easily load it with an easy bar across your lap. So not only are you really locked into the point where you can't really cheat, sway, momentum, and the form will be the same every time, you can really actually progress the load, you know, smaller than, you know, like hanging a dumbbell or something from you. You can get like 2.5, 5 pounds, 10 pounds by loading the easy bar. So it's a progressable exercise that you can do basically in your garage. So I'll show y'all what it looks like, and then I'll show y'all what it looks like with the modification that we're gonna do it with today. It's a little more equipment, but I feel like it really makes a big difference for the mechanics of the exercise. So let me show you what it looks like first without that modification. So have the bar set to where you can fully hang without your butt touching the ground. You want your butt as close to the ground as it can be without actually touching the ground. So I'm going to full stretch right now with my scapula completely let go. We get my feet up here. Right here, and then just like everything else we do on back day, first thing to move is going to be that scapular retraction to get my back engaged. So scapular retraction and straight up, really focusing on driving your elbows to the middle of your lower back each rep. When you're doing these, you should feel a major amount of lat engagement, not just in your upper back. If you're getting it all in your upper back, try to remain more upright. Get that scapular retraction down. Really drive the elbow to the middle of your lower back. So, that's what it looks like with no weight. I'm going to show you all what it looks like with the modification that we're going to do now. And then finally, I'll show you what it looks like, how to load it with the easy bar across your lap. So, for the modification that we're going to do, basically, the only thing you need to figure out how to do is figure it out how to attach handles to a bar. You know, the way that I like to do it is, you know, the easy straps of carabiners, that's ideal. You know, you literally can use anything as long as it's able to hang these from the bar. What we're trying to do, and I'll talk while I hang them, is by hanging these straps, we're able to get a much better alignment to get our lats engaged more, which is what I'm after whenever I'm doing a lat pull down, obviously. So why can you get it engaged more? Everything's a lot more lined up. Whenever you're on a bar, your grip's like this. No matter how hard you think about going like that, you're never gonna bend that bar in like this and get your lats more engaged and your alignment better. By fixing these handles, we take that problem out. We're able to get that alignment proper. You're able to scale them in and out. And we're able to really dial in the alignment and really get a lot more lat engagement than we would be just using the bar. So that is the why behind what we're doing. And if you have the ability to set it up, basically, the only thing that you have to keep in mind is, if I can get this strap fixed, right? Anyways,
put it on top.
You just gotta move it up so it's more proper height. And then you wanna get these shoulder width alignment. And see, we're here now, and we're able to keep the elbow tucked, still vertical torso, a lot more lower lat engagement than before. So
first thing is, it does get hard if you don't have straps, particularly gas cell straps. So make sure you strap up.
And the other plan point of this is you're much more locked in. So you'll see, we weren't able to show this yet because, like I've said in videos past, we're filming all this. So we had to steal some help to actually film this one. But your partner that you're training with, or you if you're training by yourself, need to figure out a way to be able to have something like this. Because by having something here, your feet are able to have something to push against and maintain that vertical position, and like I said, it's much more locked in and stable. What I do, and my mantra is, the more stable, the more output we get, and the more output we get, the more muscle tissue will accrue over time. And that's what we're after, right, is all the tissue. So, without further ado, I give you our version of the rack chip.
Yep. With weight. With weight and proper alignments. And progressive. So be careful not smashing your partner's tongue. That's pretty important. It's not a cold suit, huh?
The stronger you get, the more OCD you get, I guess, right? Anyways, alright.
Those eventually will all be on the bar.
Yeah.
When I use it.
But anyways, so moving on from rack chins to our main, rowing motion of the day for our lats. It's going to be a one-arm, basically barbell row kind of deal off of a landmine. If you don't have a landmine, I told you on some quarantine workout. Excuse me, that's not Rona, I swear.
I swear.
Anyways, if you don't have a landmine, the bar can go in the corner of your garage. Just make sure if it's like bare drywall, you put like wood or like a tile in there or something. It works just fine. Have your partner put his foot on the back or put a dumbbell over the back. If you have a landmine or an ability to do it like this, obviously do it that way. But without further ado, let's talk about
it. If it's just in the corner, when it gets heavier, your training partner's got to stand on the back.
So, without further ado, some things that made this exercise really work for me and really changed the feel for me is playing around with the angle that your body's facing and getting it to the point where you're in a comfortable hang with my wrist, elbow, and shoulder all in alignment, where I can really pull literally right past my leg and keep everything in alignment and really get that squeeze with my elbow, like really kind of in your head, feel like you're wrapping the elbow around your ribcage, really getting your lat as engaged as possible. Obviously, under load, you're not going to want to sit here and torque yourself. That's the last thing you want. We want to keep our shoulders as perpendicular to the ground as possible. But that's a good cue when you're here. Get that shoulder down and back. Drive the elbow back and try and wrap it around your body. That'll get your lat maximally engaged. So, let me show you what it looks like with a little weight.
And what's cool about this versus dumbbell rows is it is easier to keep your arms squared to the ground.
Yeah.
It doesn't torque you as much.
That and because, come around here real quick. Because the bar is in a landmine or in the ground, you're able to really think about driving your shoulder and elbow back, like back into the landmine. And that's what's going to engage your lat. And you think about driving it back the whole time. Even when you're in that stretch, you're still engaged back, driving, wrapping around your ribcage, getting a really good squeeze. The entire time, it should be engaged in your lat. And like I said, the thing that made the biggest difference for me was playing around with the angle. You'll see that just turned into a glorified bicep curl for me. Doing it like this, once it gets heavy, is pulling me off balance. By finding that sweet spot where everything hangs nice and right, I'm able to really keep it close to my body, and it stays comfortable and stable for me as it gets heavier. So, that in a nutshell is the coaching points for this exercise. We'll show you all what the top sets look like. I'll let Bryan talk a little before he does his set because he has some insights I'm sure I miss. And we'll get after it.
Notice how he's not swinging it or jerking it. How the bar is staying very close to his leg, almost grinding up his leg. Mom. Nice.
squeeze it up, squeeze it up, squeeze it up.
Come on, B. Come on. Good, let's go.
So, barbell rows, everybody does them, but most people do them wrong. It's really an excellent exercise if you do it the correct way. So, the way that I like to do it, same thing, all the cues are similar to the rest of the back exercises. You want to make sure you're driving your elbows back, you want your scapula contracted the whole time, right? But the angle of how you stand up, how far you lower the bar, and the most important part is, want to kill all the momentum in the body. You don't want to be slinging. It's not a deadlift. It's not some glorified trap exercise. You're trying to use your actual back to grow the weight. So here's how you set it up. Grab it about shoulder width. Step back with it. Don't bend your knees too much. You want to hinge at the hips. I like to keep my knees about slightly bent, and I like going the bar just past my patella tendon, and then I row and pull the bar into my hip. So I drive my elbows back, and I pull the bar into my hip, and I keep the bar as close to my body as possible. And I try to keep my back, the angle of my back, similar throughout the entire motion, even in the stretch position, right? So bounce my patella. Momentum stop completely, row to my hip, here, down to my, past my patella, get the stretch and stop momentum, row into my hip, here. So, that's what it looks like with a little bit of weight on.
Come on. So, if you haven't been able to figure it out by now, we're pretty wrecked. So, these deadlifts will be interesting. There it is. Now I can see the light, right? Still figuring the self-filming thing out. But yeah, so those bent over rows and those one arm T-bar rows, obviously you're stabilizing with your erectors, so it should feel like you have like balloon animals for erectors already, and now you're about to do either banded deadlifts or Dorian deadlifts if you don't have the bands. So we'll get that set up and talk to y'all. Right, so we have two options for you today depending on what you have. If you don't want to do our MacGyver deadlift band board, which I strongly recommend you do, the easiest option and the least equipment is going to be doing deadlifts at the end of the day, kind of Dorian-esque style. And what we mean by that is continuous tension. I'll show you on the bar, but basically you're going to unrack it. You don't want to take it from the ground. We're not trying to do it from the ground. We're not trying to train that portion. We're trying to use the portion of the exercise that's really intensive for the back. That's why we have the band so overloaded on the top of the deadlift we're about to do. And that's why if you're doing the band-free Dorian version, you're going to unrack it, take a step back, you're going just past your patella, and then coming right back up. Just past the patella, coming right back up, thinking about trying to push that bar through your body the whole time, which is going to keep your lats engaged the most. You do not need to do this. It drives me crazy. That's doing nothing but terribly loading your spine in a direction it's not supposed to go. From here to here, that's all you need. So I'm going to show you, it looks like it's a little bit of weight. My lower back is absolutely thrashed. And then I'll walk right over to the MacGyver board and show y'all what that looks like before we throw some weight on the bar. And I try to kill myself to keep up with like 50 pounds less than Bryan. At least I can check my ego, right?
I gotta beat you on one day. Well,
we're back. Shoulder width. We don't have it hanging. We're retracted. My lats are already engaged. We are hinging at the hips, coming right past the patella, and pulling that bar through our bodies, keeping tension in the lat the whole time. Even with 225, it is lighting me up right here. So, that's what those look like. You want to work up to a hard set of, you know, 6 to 8. We're not trying to do cardio with these. We really are trying to load. If you want to do the MacGyver deadlift band board, I'll make this really quick. This is a sheet of plywood, two sheets doubled up, screwed down. These are different lengths of 2x4s, one down the edge, one for bracing, one cut at an angle for bracing. Everything is wood nailed and screwed together. There are eye bolts for the band pegs, and we are pulling off of a block per se, which is rubber mats, and a 45 pound plate hiding there in the bottom. So, the reason we're doing this is we are trying to overload the portion of the exercise that we are after, and that is the top portion that is overloading our back. So, we don't have a game scale, but if we had to guess, I'd call it about 180 to 200 pounds of tension at the top, and it rolls on immediately. All of the tension's out of the band already, so the second you start moving the bar, there's tension through it. So, show y'all what this looks like, and then we will get on to moving up to our top set. One thing that's going to be really important that you do, especially on your heavier sets, is to really lock yourself in. Get on the bar, get your feet set, get your shoulders down and back, hold tension through the bar, feel it in your lat, and then keep it in your lat the whole time. Don't just rip the bar off the ground.
Yep. Come on, let's go.
Yep. Come on, up.